How do you design a test that they can't get, ask Google to give them the answer?
If you're doing it at home on a snow day, for instance. You're asking about the test.
Yeah.
I mean, well, some things aren't going to step forward in technology quite as quickly. You probably have to close the lid before we take the test. So.
Okay. The other thing is,
books don't have lids.
When they crash, who fixes them? You?
Replace. Yeah, this is, I mean, let me say, the Chromebook is like a textbook, is like anything else that's in the classroom. If I need it to deliver effectively instruction on a day-by-day basis, I'm going to provide it for the student. And if there's something wrong with it, if it doesn't meet the expectation, it doesn't serve the purpose, I got to take care of it. So if they are broken, if there's a problem, that'll be on us. Yeah.
The other thing I was wondering is, maybe you should give adult education to teach us how to use these things.
Well, we have an experiment going on right now. One of our board members is getting his board packet via his own computer. He has a handheld. So we did okay the first meeting. So Rusty is sort of our experiment, and see how he does. And because we'd like to, at some point, go paperless with our school board. I mean, I give them a packet of paper that's this thick, and I would much rather them have a tool that they can use, and they all have computers and handhelds, so we could do that. So we're working on it.
My last question is, how do you control what they look at on the computer? Because there's all kinds of opportunities.
Oh, there sure is.
And word gets around pretty fast.
Right, and so. They're quick, and they are very quick, and they're very astute on these computers.
Sure they are.
And we have firewalls that prevent them from going outside of those places that they're allowed.
Could that be an issue that the parents would be only
parents need to really, boy, that's a good, that's a great comment, Sonny, because parents have to be vigilant. They have to know what their kids are doing. They can't just say, go to your room and work on your computer. The computer should be done in the place in the home that's very visible, that's very active, that has a lot of eyes and ears. And it isn't just the places that they go and the programs, but also some of the text messages that are going on that are not appropriate. Parents need to be very engaged in that, and not to be afraid to say something. You know, like that's not acceptable. And we do. We've done some nights with parents to help them understand those kinds of things that can happen with technology. Good point. Good point.
I want you to know, and the people that are listening at home, there's management software, Google management software, that's running on all of these Chromebooks that are purchased by the district. I went out and bought a Chromebook for child one and child two, my twin daughters, as they went into middle school this year. On its own, the Google Chrome environment does not provide the same kind of parental controls that you'd like to have. But in our educational environment, with the management overlays that we've got, they're much better. So the Chromebooks that these kids will be using, with all of the limitations and the filters and such that are in place, will protect, and have to, because we have to comply with CIPA, the Child Internet Protection Act, mm-hmm. as a part of what we do. But if you happen to go out and buy one of your own, you'll find that, like I found, that I have to do a whole lot of vigilant oversight, because they're smarter than you think they are, and Google is still warming up to the challenge of providing me the kind of permissions, rights, and controls that I want to keep them on task and on target. So,
actually, the kids will figure out how to get over it.
No, they're smart. They're smart kids.
Well,
thank you.